Can you reverse gray hair? Today I want to talk about a topical peptide called GreyVerse, which has been getting some attention in the cosmetics industry as a possible real-life solution for gray hair. Let's look at the proof. If you're not familiar with GreyVerse, it is a synthetic peptide that's technically called Palmitoyl Tetrapeptide-20, and it is thought to reverse gray hair by working through two different mechanisms. One of them is it is an antioxidant, and the other is it's said to mimic the action of alpha-melanocyte-stimulating hormone. This is the hormone that stimulates melanin production. Okay, so what is the proof? Some research suggests that GreyVerse ramps up an antioxidant enzyme called catalase and reduces hydrogen peroxide production by as much as 30%. Elevated hydrogen peroxide levels in hair cells can block melanin production and are thought to contribute to both gray hair and white hair too. Now in this same paper, researchers also discuss how they tested the GreyVerse peptide in 15 men who were dealing with premature gray hair. More specifically, these men used 3 milliliters of GreyVerse daily for 3 months. They reported that not only did the GreyVerse peptide stimulate the production of melanin-producing cells, but also melanin itself increased too. Now those are pretty interesting results, but again, this study lasted 3 months. I bring it up because other than showing us this picture, which I don't think matters to most people, no real life before and after pictures of these men were provided. And that's weird because you'd think that after 3 months, they would have seen some visible changes in hair color. Fortunately, our story doesn't end here. In this next paper with a very bold title, a 25-year-old woman in India went to a doctor with complaints of prematurely graying hair. And what I like about this paper is they actually did blood tests and they ruled out hypothyroidism or vitamin deficiencies as a potential cause of her premature gray hair. After that, it said the doctor prescribed the GreyVerse peptide and the woman was instructed to use 1 milliliter twice a day on the areas of her scalp where she was seeing the gray hair. She's also instructed to use both biotin supplements and vitamin B5 as well. That part looked a little weird to me because apparently they already ruled out vitamin deficiencies as a potential cause of her condition. Nonetheless, what happened? So after 3 months, it's reported that they started to see some improvements in her gray hair, so much so that they instructed the woman to actually reduce her GreyVerse use to only 1 milliliter a day. And after 5 months, they say she achieved an over 90% improvement in her hair color. And they go on to say that her hair color remained its natural color for at least 9 months. And as further proof, they show us these before and after pictures. The first picture is what she looked like in the beginning. You can definitely see a fair amount of gray hair. The middle picture is what she looked like 5 months later, and then the final picture on the right is how she appeared after 9 months. Now, I would have liked to have seen her hair from other angles. Nonetheless, based on these pictures, I do see a big difference. Now, these are definitely impressive results. I will say I've read this paper, and here are some things to be aware of. Number one, they don't say if she continued to use GreyVerse after her hair had returned to its normal color. Did she stop using the peptide after 5 months, or did she continue to use it up to 9 months later when that final picture was taken? Number two, who supplied the GreyVerse peptide? Keep watching. I'm going to talk more about that at the end of the video. Number three, they don't tell us how much biotin or vitamin B5 she was using. And that brings us to this paper, which looks like a letter to the editor of a medical journal where dermatologists are describing what happened when they tested the GreyVerse peptide in 14 men and women. So in a nutshell, these 14 people are instructed to use 2 milliliters of GreyVerse each day for 6 months. After the study, they conclude that of those 14 people, 6 of them showed no improvements whatsoever. However, when they surveyed these people on what they thought of their results, 6 of those 14 thought that GreyVerse worked really well, and another 5 people thought it worked somewhat well. That said, when they looked at all the data, the doctors deemed that the improvements from GreyVerse were not statistically significantly better. Here are before and after pictures of 2 of the men who were in this study. The guy on the top is said to have had good results with GreyVerse, contrasted by the guy below him who is said to have shown no improvements. Personally, I don't see an improvement in either of these guys, but you tell me in the comments below what you think. Okay, so what do I think of GreyVerse? So the good news is that none of the reports I saw reported any side effects. That's really good news for people who are intrigued and want to experiment with this for yourself. In contrast, the not so good news is that I didn't see a lot of human clinical research on GreyVerse, and the papers that I did see could be a little better in my opinion. So at this point, I think if you're gonna try Graverse, go into this with eyes wide open. I do think results will vary. Some things that may influence the outcomes could include what's causing your gray hair, how long you've had your gray hair, and also how old you are may play a role as well. If you are still intrigued and you wanna try the Graverse peptide for yourself, you wanna look for either the word Graverse, that is the word that's being promoted to the public, or in the ingredients of a product, you want to look for Palmitoyl Tetrapeptide 20, that is sometimes abbreviated as PTP-20. Also, Graverse is produced by a multinational cosmetics company called Lucas Meyer. From what I could tell, the Lucas Meyer company appears to license out Graverse to other companies who then use it in their formulas for anti-gray hair alongside other ingredients. When I searched, I didn't see anyone selling Palmitoyl Tetrapeptide 20 by itself as a solution for gray hair, although again, I did see it in multi-ingredient products. So if you're still with me and you're still intrigued and you want to try Graverse for yourself, here's what you want to do before making a purchase. You want to reach out to the company that is using the Graverse peptide and you want to ask them what percent of Graverse they are using, because according to the research that I have seen, a 2% solution of Graverse is what's used in the research. Oh, and by the way, if you ever see this stuff listed on the supplement facts label as a dietary supplement, I think you should be skeptical. As of right now, there is no evidence that taking this stuff orally will produce the same benefits as putting it topically on your scalp.